After the first multi-layered exercise, we will carry on and try to make a print with some structures. So I start again from empty canvas and I prepared some items. A nice postal stamp. I have a file which I will use for color printing, and I can use two different files for varnish or even for white. And then I had the contour prepared, you know, just in case I need to print this on plexiglass. So what I want to reach is that actually this stamp is printed and that you can see the text and the head of the queen in a varnish or white structure. How to do so? I will start printing this one as white to get some thickness, so it's exactly prepared on the canvases I use. If I use my my align buttons, I can align it to the lower right corner. So this one, if I select my layering, I will print as white ink. I will make a second one, which is meant for color. And in that, of course, I will add my color file. And I will make a third one for varnish. And let's use some varnish structure in total over here. So this is ready. I have a file for white to build up structured. White ink does that the fastest. I have a file in color which I will print over the white ink, and I will end with a varnish file. And I would like the varnish to be glossy. Now, right now, this tool is only capable of using the old glossy varnish method, which is fine for me, actually. So specify print mode. We at least want some quality now, so I go for the fine, fine, and fine mode. The white, I will switch to high density because I need this one to make structure, so as much as possible. The varnish, I will select my gloss finish, and you see this is switching to the old method, which is fine. We will demonstrate that one first. The new method comes on later. And I will still switch to large dot to have some faster calculating power of my computer. So this is it. All my files are set, and I will send this to the layer editor, all valid layers in the way that I have created them. So he sends the white, now he sends the color, you see it's flashing again, now he sends the varnish. And I need to wait now until my driver is ready with preparing the files. My files are prepared. They are now in my layer. So my files are prepared. They are now inside my layer editor. And if I check the preview, then I have, of course, my color file, my white file, and a varnish file. So in this case, my three files are ready. And I will again use the multi-layer printing. The old way of glossy varnish only works in the multi-layer printing, but I'm using it for a second reason, you will see. At the bottom, my first layer should be the white, followed by the color, and followed by the varnish, the glossy varnish layer. Now this will give me three tables, and I said I wanted to do some structure. Never mind the name, I used that file to create varnish, but I can use it to create white as well. It's just the name I have given here, which might be a bit confusing because that one actually is white ink now. I go to details, and the first layer, I will print this four times. Apply. That's that four layers of white, one layer of color, one layer of varnish, six layers in total. And indeed, you see, the program shows me he will do six tables. I want to speed up things a little bit, just for demonstration. It's not necessary that the machine prints in Unidir. So I go to my expert settings, where I can force the machine to print in bidirectional. All set. and print. So as you can see, my first layer of white ink is nearly finished. My software is preparing the other pages. He's already putting 5 pages in the machine's memory. So when this one finishes first, the others will follow. You can see something here, and moving, second layer. In the meantime, my software is finished and just dumped all 6 of these files in the machine's memory. Just take a look at this. Oh yes. Perfect. Layer structure is present. So the machine will now automatically start to print the color on top of that. And after that, he will do the glossy varnish. Later on, I will explain how the ink physics and how the lamp can be controlled to create glossy and matte effect. In this case, it's done. It's done because he is, so the color image is coming out. In this case, I will do the glossy varnish because I will print with the lights off or almost off. Table will go back and he will cure afterwards. That's actually the old method. With our new lamp in 6 segments, we can do it in a faster way as well. But for the moment, the layout and print tool only supports the old one. The layer editor supports the new one, and we can manipulate that a little bit. Color file is nearly finished. Please observe, my lamp is on, so I am curing directly while I am printing. After the color file, my varnish will be printed, and since it's a glossy varnish, he will print with the lamp off. The queen looks fantastic. Compared to my previous file, the lamps are very dimmed. They should now be only at like, I think 2%. I'm hoping they are. The ink should still be, the varnish should still be more or less liquid. And I might stumble upon a new bug here, because they are, I think, burning way too strong. We'll see. Table is going back for extra curing. The extra curing, if you use glossy varnish, in the old method, of course, the extra curing is always the complete table. There is no getting around it. Mind you, it's going quite fast. It's a 4-scan mode, and especially since I'm in bidirectional now, this is going reasonably fast. Okay, it did work. So while printing the glossy varnish, he keeps the lamps at a low percentage, but I was surprised by the visibility of the light. But it did actually work. The print is glossy. You can see if my light reflects in the right way. The print is quite glossy. So he's still busy with the curing action, which is always the complete table. Let's just reach in there. Oh yes, Her Majesty the Queen, and I can feel the structure, even though the double density white, the high density didn't actually work as it should, but we'll try that one again. And so this is my first example. We will crank this up to a higher difficulty. And I will use the new method of glossy varnish.